I've opened up document ODP04, a simple doc, part 2.ODP, and the .ODP stands for Open Document Presentation. I do have those up on the frugalcomputerguide.com website in case any of you want to download them. We're going to view this document as a slideshow, and depending on the setup, we will see things differently. The first way we're going to look at this is with a single screen, as if we were creating this from our laptop, not connected to a projector or a second screen. I will click on Slideshow and start from first slide. There's our first slide, and we see these black bars on the sides. To get rid of those, I'm going to press Escape to cancel out, and I'm going over to Format, Page, and here we see the format is screen 4x3. This monitor is actually a 16x9 screen, so I'm going to choose 16x9. Clicking OK. Now I'm going back to Slideshow, start from first slide, and we see that our slide fills up the entire screen. My output is looking good, but if you still get black bars on the top and bottom, or on the sides, you may have to change that page format again. When I click my mouse, we go to the next slide. I can also use Page Up and Page Down to go forward and backwards through my slides, as well as my arrow keys, arrow down and arrow up. When I get to the end, the slideshow ends, and pressing my arrow down again, or clicking, shows the end of the slideshow. We can also cancel out of that slideshow in the middle by pressing Escape, as we did earlier. Going back into Slideshow, start from first slide. If I hold down Control and press B, the screen goes black. Pressing Control B again brings that back. We can also hold down Control and press W and make the screen white. I'm pressing Escape to cancel out again. Let's look at some other slideshow options. We saw the start from first slide. Start from current slide can come in handy if for some reason we had to stop our presentation and wanted to start again from the slide we left off. I would come down to the slide we left off, select that, then go to Slideshow, start from current slide. And we start with that slide and continue our slideshow. I'm going to click on the first slide and go back to Slideshow. Slideshow settings. We're going to talk about this one in the next video. Now we're down to rehearsed timings. Clicking that, we see our first slide and a little timer in the lower left-hand corner. This is showing us how much time has passed since we started this slide. When I go to the next slide, we see the clock restarts at zero, so we can then rehearse how much time we spend on that slide. If we want to rehearse a timing on a specific slide, we would just select that slide, go into Slideshow, Rehearse Timings, and we start with that slide and the timer in the lower left-hand corner. So this is just like start from current slide, but this time we have a timer in the lower left-hand corner. Escape cancels me out. Slideshow jump to last slide edited. Takes me to the bottom one here. I am going to edit this slide now. I'll change interest to interested. Save. Going to the first slide. Slideshow jump to last slide edited. And it takes me to this thank you again. I'm going to close the presentation and reopen it. Now I'm going into Slideshow, jump to last slide edited, and it jumps me to the slide we edited last before we closed the presentation. Interaction, custom animation, and slide transition. We will come back to those, but not for some time. We still have a lot to cover before we get to those topics. Down at the bottom, we've got Show Slide and Hide Slide. These do the same things as if I right-click on a slide and click Hide Slides. This will no longer show in the presentation. Starting the slideshow from the beginning shows us our first slide, our second bullet point, we skip the first one, and then we've got our thank you slide, and then we're done. So hiding it does not delete it, it just prevents it from showing up in a presentation. And we can hide multiple slides by selecting them, right-clicking again, show slide brings that back. Going into slideshow again, down at the bottom, we've got something called custom slideshow. And before we get to this, I'm going into the workspace and I'm going to click on the slide sorter. Now we see all our slides on this window. If we had more than one page, we'd get a scroll bar here to scroll down. And I'm going back into slideshow, custom slideshow, and we're going to create a different order for these same slides. And I know you're probably thinking, why don't I just save this presentation as a different name and rearrange the slides and pictures as needed? Most likely, most of us would probably do that. But back in the day when disk space was limited and photos took up a lot of disk space, creating a custom slideshow with the same slides to save space really made a lot of sense. So to create our custom slideshow, I'm going to select New, and this shows us all our four slides. We're going to give this a new name. I will call this the frugalcomputerguy.com-slideshow. I will create my slideshow as slide 1, slide 2, slide 1 again, slide 3, slide 1, and slide 4. Clicking OK. Now to use the custom slideshow, I'm going to check this button and start the slideshow. There we have slide 1, slide 2, slide 1 again, slide 3, slide 1, and slide 4. I'm going to create another custom slideshow. Oh, and press remote. We missed this one earlier. This is there to enable a Bluetooth slide advancer if you have one. I do not have one of those. There's nothing special you need to set for a USB slide advancer. I have tried that by plugging it in and it works right out of the box. Back down to custom slideshow. I'm going to add a new one. I will call this one the frugalcomputerguy.com slideshow 2. And for this one, I'm going to select them all. Move them to the right. I will add another slide 4. And select slide 4 and move it under slide 1. Let's add another one. This time I will move this one under slide 2. So we go 1, slide 1, slide 4, slide 2, slide 4, slide 3, slide 4. And that would be our second slideshow. Clicking OK. Now we can choose the second slideshow or the first one. I'll leave it at the second. And we'll start that one. There we have our first slide. Slide 4, slide 2, slide 4, slide 3, slide 4. And we're done. I'm going to save this document as ODP 05, a simple document, part 3. And save. In the next video, we're going to continue our look at the slideshow settings. If you like these videos, please tell a friend.